continue improving the studio with small stuff. About this little set here. This is a backdrop stand kit. It comes with three different backdrops. And I thought maybe we could have it put it as a test, put it behind here. And then one can also use it as a green screen, even if there are three different colors. Could use that, but mainly I think I would like to be able to cover this area out to about here. And this is a more enclosed space. A nicer background. So let's open it up and see what it looks like. It wasn't that expensive. Now this is the simpler version, so you can't actually roll up the cover, so this is more like a permanent, semi-permanent installation. Oh, there's the green screen. Comes with some other stuff. Where it comes with white. And it comes with black. That's the material. And it comes with these clips to set up. I have to find the other cup, fell on the floor. So, this is the main bag. And lights and everything. Oh, screw it. Okay, I'll just look at the manual and then continue. Okay. Well, that wasn't that bad. The only thing that wasn't in the instructions is why have they provided extra wing nuts, but maybe it's just because people lose them, I suppose. But they are for... for the tripods. So maybe just nice enough to include. So anyway, you're going to have the set of the ones that go in the center, and you need to use the minimum length. It's going to be these, which has the holes on the end. Because you need two. You need to use those two. So let's see how it'll... like this, and you put it on the end. So that way. And then the thing is that these are, can't get it completely up against the walls. There's going to be a gap. 20 centimeters from the wall, closest. Maybe one could get it a little bit closer. Let's see. Centimeters in both directions. Something like that. So it's going to be like two sections then. That's going to so then you take this one and then we can, actually I should put it on the on this truck first. We'll probably try the green first, even though I have green here. Make it as small as possible. The wing nut off. The same as we did on the other side. And they did say you can iron the material and wash it. Probably going to be a bit wrinkly. So let's click together. Okay, now then, say we will take it. We'll just do a test, we'll throw it off. Do final adjustments to it. Then we need to decide how long we want to take. Goes up to 2 meters, so could actually make it go to the roof. In theory, if it doesn't need the stand to be bigger to be able to stand upright properly. past it. That's looking a bit wobbly. Some adjustments going to be needed. Ah, you can still, I can see it in the picture. But it would need to be a little bit higher. Okay, that's odd. I thought they said it could be higher than that. What am I going to do now? Let's see. The instructions. Adjustable height is only up to 2 meters.
Okay, I have to accept it.
That was a little bit taller. Oh well, I can always put something underneath the stands. Somehow I missed that detail. I thought it was 240 millimeters, because now it's not going to be high enough for my use case. Ah, sitting use case, of course. Not this standing use case. Okay, let's see what the material looks like. I made three of the clips, one of the clips fell on the floor, so I have to go pick it up. Legs are very wobbly as they are now. Just have to get another clip. Creases. But that's theoretically the way I wanted to have it. And sadly, it could be made a little bit wider. But the height is now 2 meters, so this is the max height. That's not going to be enough for this scenario. Oh well, that's a pity. One learns. Maybe I'll have to consider buying another kit. Anyway. If you thought this was interesting, consider subscribing. other people looking for this type of stuff. Maybe pass the message on. They probably get some info about the problems that I've actually come up with. And I'll see you in the next one. Aha! My mistake. It's actually the leg part is the final height adjustment. So if you pull the pipe up so you get the different orientation for the leg support, then you can get it to go to the designated around 2 meters. But then I have this clearance problem here, because then the legs are spread out a little bit more than I would like. I mean, it's actually my problem with this area where I just have a wall. I would need to have it. So I might need to do some engineering where I'm going to actually do away with this and have it hooked up on the side wall and stuff. So, but anyway, as it is, it'll work for standing position. I think it needs to be ironed. I mean, as you see, all these creases. So if it was ironed, and then I have to position it a bit better. I think with a little bit of sorting out, I think I'll get it to work. Anyway, thanks for watching. Yeah, I've got a bit of a problem with the backdrop thing. I need to get it closer to the wall, and I would like to actually cover this section. And since it comes with 3 cloths, I was thinking I would customize the parts I have. So there was 4 rods. So what I'm thinking of doing is I'm going to make a custom holder up here, up there, get rid of this door stopper because it's not really needed anymore, and then install one of these up there. So maybe the black one on there, or the white one. We'll see, we're going to have to test. Now I thought I'd keep the green one for the back, because then we can actually replace it with some. Test to replace it with some picture, but it still needs to be ironed. It's got very, very big creases in it. So anyway, I will start working on this and record a little bit when it's actually done. And then this is an outside door in a climate where it gets rather cold, so this is going to be insulated for the winter. Okay, that's the brackets gone. The door stopper. We're planning not to open this door, not much. Okay, back to bracket building for the backdrop. Okay, let's run the tape. Okay, so what I've done now is I've taken these bars and then I've designed and printed a holder to go up there. And then there's another one that goes in here. Same design, and then it continues around. And then it comes to one of the actual legs that actually came with the kit. Now we just need to get the material and hang it up. Okay, let's get this pilot hole. across with a drill across. Slightly easier. Soft hammer. Right. my fault. It's so hard to see. Not enough light. Should have taken my headlamp. Measurement equipment is not here. Yeah, well, one gets a feeling of what stuff one needs to bring here. No, it's too big. Okay, I can see that it went through the pipe. I'm just taking it out. Checking. A little bit of burning. That's not that bad. It's a hole. Hands off. So done. Okay, that's both of them up. I don't know if I'm not 100% satisfied. It's the corner there, it might be a bit of a problem. But I made some custom clips also to make it easier to get it close to the wall than the other ones. Were too big, and I drilled a hole in the pipe so that I can actually move the stand to a little bit more central location, so it doesn't block my chairs and stuff. Okay, I think it'll be time to make a little test video. See what it looks like. Yeah, see, testing. Yeah. Testing. Oh, this is interesting. We got these screens off and on. I'm gonna see if I can actually use the green section or even the black section to replace some content. So expect to see this video again, but with replaced back picture.